Hello everyone, it's George and welcome back to Call of Dragons. As dedicated free-to-play player who played this game for more than 500 days, I'm excited to share some insider tips and tricks with you. Stick around and let's dive in. As you can see, we are continuing our fight against way stronger alliance than we are, but as long as we have some kind of activity, we will try our best to be a good defense against them, right? At first, last time, like yesterday, we fought like for 10 hours straight, even more. And of course, now they are trying their best to break through and take the pass, which will be, well, depending on their resources, because they have actually spent, I think, quite a lot. If not, then I will be really surprised. And yeah, I guess simply because the opportunities I have to get more merits by the fights and having the success in general with the less powerful alliance than they are, of course they are going to push for the spire, right? For us now it's important to defend. This is the first push, of course, because of them having amazing amount of infantry players who are playing all the time. I think like they had tanks, they had infantry for 10 hours straight, and that's the main weakness for our alliance, right? So far, yet again, we are fighting against infantry. So far, I'm having Bertrand on the bench so far, because whenever Walder will be gone, then I will be using my Bertrand and Tohar, right? We need to defeat these infantry players as soon as possible. Without that, it will be almost impossible for us to defend this spire, right? Of course, we are waiting for our allies. We are hoping that they will come out to us really soon, because, well, we are fighting against almost twice as big alliance as we are, and we need some kind of help here, right? But as always, I will try my best as a free-to-play player to get as much merits as possible out of this fight. And unfortunately, so far we are only hitting infantry, which will have high effect on our merit score. That's generally how it happens, right? Merit score are depending on what you are actually hitting. If you are hitting backline, then congratulations, you will be having high merit score. But if your main target is only infantry players, yeah, it's pretty sad, but that's the general truth how everything is done in Call of Dragons in terms of merits which you are getting on the battlefield. This is not all, right? They will have more and more infantries here. The main problem for us have been to touch their backline, which has the damage, right? And also this flyer guy, of course, if we're gonna have some free time hitting him, that should be quite good also, right? Yeah, we finally destroyed three infantry legions or even more, but the problem is that they have more and more. But yeah, let's try, let's see. Maybe in a couple of minutes the situation will change and we will try to move them back. That's the hope, but the understanding is that this fight will be quite hard for us to play, right? Finally, some damage, I think, to backline. Because infantry players went back, they are trying to destroy the spire at first and then recapture, of course. It's not about who will get highest amount of merits for us right now. It's important to know that our main goal is simply to defend and to win the battle, right? Without that, it will be really stupid to fight and lose troops and use your resource healing. It's the main reason, right? Everybody wants to win, and if you want to win, you have to be active in Call of Dragons. That's the normal practice so far. Yeah, yet again, two infantry heroes which are super strong and they are not going to die fast, unfortunately. But yeah, I will try my best to get to stay alive longer. It will be quite hard because, like, for now I have not even got targeted even at least once, and the damage which I have on my legion is purely from counter-attack damage, which has a high impact, especially for 2-3 players, because, well, tier 5s are having huge amount of counter-attack damage. This guy is slowly defeating our backline. He's rushing in using artifact and going back, which is quite annoying. And finally, we managed to defeat these infantry players who were defending for hours, right, last time. Yeah, yet again, one more cavalry trip, which is quite annoying. It's good that we are having some free time attacking at least something, but of course it would be much better for us to hit mages or even marksmen, right? But at some point we have to defeat this cavalry player, because he's just killing the refilling legions, which is quite bad. Yeah, I hope I will catch them right now. Yeah, finally I think somebody actually used the taunt, which is the torque for the infantry, and finally we will be able to take down this infantry player, which is quite an here. Unfortunately, the Walder and Wellin hero pair is quite low because of the lot of counter attack damage, which affects every single legion, especially as you are as the tier 4 player. You are receiving quite high amount of counter attack, unfortunately. But if I will get targeted even for a second in this kind of fights, I will get melted. That's the general practice so far, and I hope I will continue in a way like I have been so far, right? Let's move, let's continue, let's rush them out from our territory, because they are really really annoying. They are killing our refilling legions, and that has a big impact on the front line, which needs to be get fixed quite soon. I don't want to hit Hosk. My actually Hosk and Kinara has highest amount of counter attack damage. I will try to join my main group, my main backline, and of course all the refilling legions are doing same, so we will have better effect on the battlefield with the main group than we are running towards the cavalry heroes, which will be of course a lot faster than we are right now. And in general, like, cavs are way way faster mages, right? Alright, I'm with the main group. I will try to use my Phoenix Eye here. We have a couple of multiple targets, which will be great to use the Phoenix Eye. I think if you are using artifacts correctly in fights, that's the indication how well you are doing and if you are getting the highest amount of merits which you can possibly get. Of course, I'm not expecting like 20-30k merits as a free-to-play player against like tier 5 whales, players who are having more than 100 million power, but at least the yellow merits will be quite good success for me. That's how I generally look at it, merit scores. Like, if you get yellow ones, you did well. It doesn't really matter if you are a free-to-play player, if you are a pay-to-win player, yellow merits always feels good. Of course, if you are 100 million power player, you want to have like 50-60k merits per legion, but this is not the case for me right now. I'm just trying to survive and trying to fill and add as much DPS as possible with the normal free-to-play friendly hero pairs such as Walder and Wellin. Of course, my Walder is awakened, the Wellin is like normal. I have not spent a single extra legendary token on my Wellin, so if I will get yellow merits from this fight, I will be already happy with the performance in this fight, right? Of course, it will be super hard for us to defend alone against these targets, but we will try our best. Also, I need to add that my hospital is full. I have almost 1.5 million wounded troops already before this legion's fight, so I'm quite limited in terms of heroes and troops in the game. Now it would be perfect if I was able to charge my Phoenix Eye here, and if I will be able to do that, that's this infantry hero here, and let's see if I will have enough time to use this moment. And yep, I think I managed to do this, and if I will be able to use artifact on, yep, I guess at least on one target, that's totally fine also. Of course, now it will be better if Walder and Wellin will go home, because the amount of troops inside the legion is really really low. And yeah, let's try to do that, let's try to be a little bit aggressive, and the bench hero pair, which is Bertrand and Ohar, will change and substitute this like actually best performing hero pair for me in these fights, right? Like, all the hero pairs which are having skill which is dealing damage to multiple target is always great. And yeah, let's check now Bertrand and Tofar, and let's see how well this hero pair is going to do, right? This hero pair has 5-1-1-1 on the skills, both of them, nothing really special. I decided to build this hero pair because I got Mirage Orb from the Universal Artifact Keys, and then I built like Shadow Page Rick, and yeah, the hero pair was kind of ready. All was left to add like couple of levels on the main skill, and yeah, kind of ready. But in terms of like performance, if I'm gonna compare it to Aldrian Velin, of course, lower merits. But it depends, right? It depends on fight, depends on target, and yeah, like Mirage Orb is great, but it's more good if for the single target damage, not as much as a like multiple targets. That's why Phoenix Eye is much better in terms of dealing damage to a couple of targets at the same time. That's why I think Waldron Velin has been getting more merits in this kind of fights, because enemies are kinda staying in the same space, and you have a higher chance to deal damage to multiple targets with Phoenix Eye than with Mirage Orb. That's my honest opinion. Here I will be using Mirage Orb on infantry because they are standing together and we will have some additional damage to them. And also one thing which I noticed about this hero pair is that it's much better to stand still and attack because of the skill called Channeling Plateau. You need like 5 seconds in order to finish casting that skill, and whenever you will finish the casting the full skill, that's the moment when you did the highest amount of damage you could with the skills you are having on Bertrand and Tohar. Yeah, I'm looking forward for this season. I think fights will continue from now on, because like last couple of like 20 days or 25 days was kind of boring if you ask me. We were generally waiting until the pass 4 and 3 would open, and finally when pass 4 opened, this been happening for 2 days straight. Of course, difference is huge in terms of power and in terms of resources against our alliances, but honestly I don't really look too much about that. I'm having a lot of fun fighting against the Call of Dragons, and if the fights will be long and if the fights will be for a couple of days, I'm all about that, right? But yeah, sometimes it's quite annoying to only hit infantry players, but that's the reality of our alliance. If enemy is stronger, of course it will be visible in terms of every single aspect of the game. Yeah, finally we will destroy these infantries, and maybe we're gonna have some extra time for some backline. And yeah, of course my Mirage Orb is getting charged, and let's see where I will be able to use the artifact. And yeah, as I have said it before, artifacts is like one of the best source of every generation in the game. That's not even a secret. If you are having 5 level artifact, congrats, you will get high amount of merits during the fights, right? Here, of course, I want to use Mirage Orb, but I think enemy will be going out of the range. Let's see, maybe here. Yeah, I guess this is a great use. And also, whenever you are using Mirage Orb, it needs like a couple of seconds to cast it. The animation, which is quite annoying also. That's why Phoenix Eye is, I think it's a bit faster. It's just a bam, boom, right? And it's on the head of the enemy, and Mirage Orb needs like cast time. It's some time to actually fly toward the target. So that's like things which have different effects during the battlefield. And if you are not actually fighting, you won't gonna understand these small details in these fights, right? I think here we are having Fog of War, which is amazing actually. We won't gonna get targeted anymore, which is perfect news, right? I hope that's the case. Yep, that's the case. If I will be able to send one more Waldron Velin with this fog, will be amazing, but yeah, unfortunately that's not the case. I have tried my best to fight for like 3 or 4 hours yesterday, and as a free-to-play player, it's quite hard to survive such a prolonged fights, because generally everybody is using resource healing. You are not doing that, and it has a high effect on PvP for sure. Of course, if they are not targeting my legion, I will only target their backline, which is the most important target right now. Only legion type I think which can target my legion inside is infantry, in my opinion, or sometimes if I will get visible from the fog, that's the only time when the mages can attack. Yeah, I can use my Rojob one more time. I think that that will be like one of the last uses. And I really, really hope I will get a yellow merit from Bertrand and Tohar. Generally, that's not the case. Mainly, I get like 10 to 11k merits with this hero pair, because yeah, it kinda needs way more skills on the levels, on the skills, than anything else in terms of strengths. And I think if you will have high levels on Tohar main skill, you will be dealing more and more damage. That's not the case in terms of Welin, I guess, with the pairing with Waldir, but that's the general idea I'm seeing by my own gameplay so far, right? I think I won't gonna be able to do one more Mirage Orb there, but I guess 3 usage was quite enough. And yeah, let's destroy this infantry and let's move towards the backline, and of course, let's move towards the builders, which are destroying the spire, which is the main target for our enemies. So yet again, more infantry. They never stop, they are always here. You can see how many infantry they are having on the bench. That's the main reason why we have been losing these fights. And yeah, I guess infantry is the indication of how well you are going to do, and unfortunately we are not having infantry. Couldn't you send me somewhere? Yeah, one is down. Let's try. I hope I'm gonna get yellow merits now, because I used the Mirage Orb pretty well in these fights. And also, I have got targeted once, but it was not for a long time. That's why I think a yellow merit should be expected also from this hero pair. It would be super amazing if I was able to use Mirage Orb one more time. The cooldown is almost done. We have infantry heroes who are close to charge it, and also we can send the Mirage Orb here against the backline, which should be the good target, in my opinion. Of course, I think, yeah, that's the great. Also, we are kinda moving forward, and if I'm going to send the Mirage Orb here, that's, yeah, that's actually what happened. And I think, finally, for Bertrand and Tohar, yellow merits are here against the 5 players. Last fights I always was getting like 9k, 10 or 11 max, and finally I think this will be the fight where I will see yellow merits on Legion 2. Simply because one big plus, we managed to stay alive quite a long time, and that's always the indication that we will get more and more merits during the fights. Yep, one last infantry, but they have more infantry here, which is quite hard to overcome. And I think the unit troop type is so low that I can be a little bit aggressive if I can put some backline. Let's try to do this. Yeah. Well, I understand that having the low amount of troops inside the Legion, you are dealing less damage, you are getting more wounded troops, but honestly, if I want to see how much merits I got from the Legion, it should be high in fight. Win the fight, so I'd really give almost no attention to that mechanic about low health. And especially if you are fighting against tier 5s, of course you are going to have low health. No chance you're gonna stand there with full health and attack anyone, because they are getting too much counter attack damage against you. Yeah, I'm quite surprised I have target of a backline for some time. And yeah, I guess that's the end of the Bertrand and Tohar. Yeah, I will check with you guys how much is my hospital by fighting for 2 days. Yeah, it's looking pretty bad. And what's most important right now is the merit score. 80k, 90k, it's all about staying alive. Of course, because of the fog of war, Bertrand and Tohar was great, because enemy was not able to target us and we had a free time attacking them. And yeah, more natural battlefield gameplay was with Walder and Welin, and we get actually fine merits. Amazing merits, if you ask me correctly, right? So yeah, that's it. I guess I'm always trying to show that you can even fight as a free-to-play player against tier 5 players pretty well. 19, 20, 80, 70, 60,000 merits per Legion as a free-to-play player against tier 5s is amazing. And if anybody is getting this kind of merits, I hope, right, they are getting well done. It means that we are fighting correctly. As always, I hope you guys liked the PvP gameplay video, because for me it's the most fun gameplay in Call of Dragons whenever you are fighting. And if you like the video, press like, subscribe, share. It always gives me more and more motivation to make more videos for this game. I wish everybody an amazing day, morning and night. We are going to see each other really, really soon. Bye bye and good luck.